There are a few pretty exciting new IoT TISTIC features in the makings, so I thought I'd give you a quick overview. Welcome to the IoTT Channel Development Lab, I am Hans Tanner. If you watched the last few videos, you know that the project that consumes most of my time right now is the Green Hat, which is a 16-channel servo decoder to drive turnouts and semaphore signals. Besides the servo output, it also provides two input lines per channel that can be used to connect buttons or sensors. Furthermore, it has two NeoPixel LEDs per channel to indicate switch or signal positions. As I have explained before, the challenge with the Green Hat development is not so much in the hardware and the functionality itself, but much more in writing a configuration web app that makes it easy for the user to set the Green Hat characteristics according to the needs of the application. I am about 90% there, so I will give you some first impressions in one of the next videos. And if you don't want to miss that, well, you know what to do. As a side effect, the Green Hat project was driving a bunch of other improvements. One of them is the new event handler functionality I introduced in the last video, which is also used for the input buttons on the Green Hat. The other improvements are additional communication interfaces. Let me show you what will become available with the next release of the IoTTSTIC software. The first new mode is DCC from MQTT. In video number 56, I implemented a smartphone DCC viewer, which allows you to see DCC commands from your track decoded to your smartphone screen. This is possible because of the DCC to MQTT mode, which picks up DCC commands from the track signal using a DCC interface and sends them via Wi-Fi to an MQTT broker, from where they make it to the smartphone. For the Green Hat, I thought it would be nice if it also could receive DCC commands via MQTT, so it could be used with any DCC system, not just those that use Loconet. So I added DCC from MQTT to the command source list. As you remember from video number 59, DCC is a one-way road. So to make it work, we need a DCC interface and a stick in DCC to MQTT mode that feeds the DCC signal to MQTT. But from there, it can be received by an indefinite number of devices that work in DCC from MQTT mode. Here is the example setup. I use a DCC interface connected to an IoTT stick that is set to DCC to MQTT. It decodes the DCC commands from the track and sends them to the MQTT broker, so I can see the commands in the DCC viewer on the smartphone. Next to it, I have a Green Hat with a servo connected to channel 0 and set to act as switch number 102. The LEDs of the channel are set to show green and red alternatively depending on the position. The stick itself is set to listen to DCC commands from MQTT, and as I send switch commands from the handheld throttle, I can see the DCC messages in the DCC viewer as well as on the Node-RED debug node, and the Green Hat successfully receives the commands and rotates the servo. Note that the Green Hat is only connected to power. The commands are sent via Wi-Fi using MQTT. No direct connection to the track is needed. Of course, since DCC is unidirectional, any input buttons will not work in this mode. Well, that's wrong. They can still work as local input buttons to set the turnout, but the input information will not make it to the command station in this case. The other thing I was looking to improve for the Green Hat is the connectivity of the IoTT stick to software like JMRI. There are several ways to connect Loconet and JMRI, and the most common method probably is using an interface like LocoBuffer USB. Already back in video number 45, I demonstrated how to make the IoTT stick work as such an interface, using the Brown Hat SO USB to serial converter, which I plan on developing in the future. But while waiting for that, I thought I am going to release the Brown Hat software so that people can use any other USB to serial converter to connect JMRI to the IoT stick. So I added the Brown Hat option to the hat list, and here is an example that shows how it works. I connect a Loconet interface to the Grove port side of the stick. On the head side, I connect a USB to serial converter, for example the popular FTDI programmer that is available for less than $2 on AliExpress. The FTDI programmer is then connected to the PC using a USB cable. In JMRI, I set up a connection to Digitrack's Loconet via LocoBuffer USB. This is done in the Preferences window under Connections. I set the serial port and the command station, and that's it. In the setup of the IoT stick, I select Brown Hat, and after a restart, I get the USB serial tab, where I set the baud rate to 56700, which is the baud rate JMRI expects for the selected mode. After saving the settings to the stick, it starts sending Loconet messages to and from JMRI and Loconet. In JMRI, I can open the Loconet viewer window and I see the messages coming along. And I can again send switch commands to the Green Hat, which now receives them from the MQTT broker using the Loconet over MQTT protocol. So, using the stick with Loconet interface and FTDI programmer is the same like using a LocoBuffer USB with one difference. The FTDI programmer does not provide galvanic separation between USB and the IoTT stick. Normally, this is not a problem when connecting to Loconet, but you may want to check that there is no difference in ground potential between your PC and the IoTT stick before connecting. The other convenient way to connect JMRI to Loconet is using Loconet over TCP, a communication protocol developed by Stefan Bormann almost 20 years ago. The link to the protocol specification is in the description of this video. Here is how it works. Loconet is connected via Loconet interface to a computer or microcontroller that provides a gateway to a network and acts as TCP server, which is usually called LB server. Other computers or microcontrollers with access to that network but without connection to Loconet itself can connect as clients to the central server. As soon as the connection is established, the server will forward all received Loconet messages to the client, and the client also can send messages to the server from where they will be sent to the Loconet. JMRI can be set up either as server or as client. Since I already have JMRI working with the Brown Hat, let's get started with making it an LB server, which is really simple. In the Preferences window, I select the Loconet over TCP server option and activate the checkbox so that the server is started whenever JMRI is starting up. The port number by default is set to 1234. Make note of that number as we will need it when setting up a client that connects to the server. After restarting JMRI, you will see an additional window opened that shows the number of clients that are connected into the server. At startup, of course, this is zero. I can now open JMRI on another computer and create a new connection for Digitrack, but this time I select Loconet over TCP. I then enter the IP address of the computer that runs the server, and after the necessary restart, JMRI will connect to the Loconet over TCP server and be able to receive and send Loconet messages as if it were physically connected to the Loconet. And in the server monitor, of course, the client count is incremented after the client connected. Next, I can also connect the IoTT stick of the Green Hat to the LB server. All I need to do is selecting LB server client as command source. After restart, the configuration screen will show the LB server tab, where I can enter the IP address and port number of the LB server I want to connect to. Make sure this is the same port number as used in the LB server setup, so 1234 in this case. I save and restart the stick, and now it connects to the LB server running on the computer and can send and receive LocalNet messages just like before, just using a different communication channel. So I can operate the servo from the handheld throttle or the JMRI turnout controller, and if I click on a local input button of the green hat, the messages make it to JMRI as well. Interesting to note that you can not only connect to an LB server running in JMRI, but it could also be somewhere else, like for example in an advanced command station like the DigiKeys DR5000, which has the option to set up and run an LB server right in the command station. Alternatively, you can also configure the IoTT stick to work as LB server, letting JMRI computers or other sticks connect into it as clients using Wi-Fi. So you can have a LocalNet interface connected to the stick, configure the stick as LocalNet over TCP server, and then go wireless from there. No more brown hat or local buffer USB needed. But wait, that's where I stand in my development work right now. So it is promising, but not yet ready to show. Stay tuned for more in the near future. And that's it for today's video. As always, I hope this information was useful, or at least interesting for you, and you learned something that gives you fresh ideas for the control system communication on your model railroad layout. If so, click the like button below to let me know. Doing so helps to promote this video and the IoTT channel in general, because YouTube likes the likes. Thanks for watching, and see you on the next video.